Hey everybody, I am Peachy117, and welcome back to The Evil Within. This chapter is chapter 10. Let's do this. Oh yeah, I went through that bookshelf. I am concerned.
How many have you killed, Ruben?
Ruben? Does he mean Ruvik?
Numbers are irrelevant. They received as they themselves gave, and they served a higher purpose. They furthered my research.
This was not mere research. The things the papers say were done to those people, those traps.
These vermin? These microbes? They're mine to do with as I please. But you are correct. This was not mere research. I'm close to perfection.
This is abhorrent.
This is my will.
So Ruvik was experimenting on a whole bunch of people. In what seemed like really, really messed up experience. Marcello was trying to stop him, but of course he sees people as just things. Mansion basement note. My children have been taken from me. Was it fate? Was it something he did? Surely not my perfect son. It was that fire. It ruined everything. Took everything. The children are not the same, and neither is Ernesto. He said he was taking care of them. That they were safe. But now he says they're gone. How could that be? A mother would note such a thing. I still hear my darling boy's voice, his laughter, and always from the basement. It cannot be. A mother needs her children. Well, wonder whose that was.
Oh no.
Okay. But yes, you always want to go into the save points first. I wonder what all the saws are for. And why they're so freaking big.
Who is that guy next door?
Do you have any idea why this world is the way it is?
What? Who are you?
Hate. Hate. Ruvik's hate. The man's consumed by it. He wants out! Wants to get his revenge! He wants back what he feels the world took from him.
It's not like he could actually get that. It's not like he could actually get that.
This world exists as long as he does.
You heard something just now?
Newspaper. Car accident. two dead. Wealthy landowner and wife die in car crash. Nightmare for family. Bodies of Ernesto and Beatriz Victoriano found in wreck. Son inherits family fortune. Why do I feel like... Okay. So, in the mansion, when Ruvik is standing in front of what I'm assuming is his parents, and he's talking to his now dead father, which I'm assuming he killed, does that mean that he took their bodies and staged a fake car crash? That way, you know, he couldn't be, like, convicted of murder or whatever. Well, that'll come in handy later. That sounds like something he would do, though. I'll do syringe recovery. Now I got 2,000. Yeah, I guess. Okay, so syringes recover more. Ha cha cha cha. Okay. So now we're on our way. More down here. That doesn't seem fun at all. That'd be very hard to trigger. I mean, it shines like so bright. This seems like a trap. And I go in anyway. Alright. Hey, hey. Okay. Gotta do the whole reload. Sneaky sneak. Oh God, that sounds horrific. whatever happened to them doesn't happen to me. Okay. Everything's really quiet. That was the door. Everything's... quiet. Everything's very quiet. They keep trying to get me with these tripwires.
Better find cover.
This is insane.
Oh! Hey, he sneaks too. Oh. Okay. So, let's not get our head chopped off. Okay. Shooting at me. Oh. Now, why didn't you swipe at her? You're just kind of like, oh my. Shot out the glass. Man, they were just gunning for me. Literally. Oh, I think I saw him. Probably wasn't the best idea to jump out in front of him there. Did he die? Man. I walked forward instead of crouching. Gotcha. Alright. Thank you. You're not dead. I know you aren't. Went down too fast. You can't fool Sebastian Castellanos. Okay. Action. Load. Get this out. Reload. Alright. Okay, there was nothing over here. Now, why did I pull out my gun? That made no sense. He was like, dee, 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 dee. I pressed R1 and I pulled out my gun instead. Hello? What's this? Probably something I need because it's going blue. Battery pack. This large portable storage cell can be used to get any electrical equipment working in an emergency. Well, that sounds useful. Oh no. Someone behind me. Why did it sound like someone was coming from this way? I guess I gotta go back out into that. The frickin'. Oh! I'm guessing there's no barbed wire on this part. Up. Up and over. Ah! Alright, he's just gonna come for me, isn't he? Wheel of Death. Ow. I was trying to disarm it. Thank you. Oh hey, this must be that thing. Boop. Cool. Okay. Way out is powered up. Let's be on our way. Through there. Man, all these things in these rooms that are locked, they just sound so gruesome. Ugh. I don't know if I want to go down there. Hey, a map fragment.
What the?
What was that? Back down there. Hey, look at my face. Hey guys, I'm Sebastian Castellanos. Okay. Starting to get a little... you know, just... to make some bolts, because I feel like we're gonna need them. Okay, so we made some bolts. Make sure we're loaded up. Hello. All right, so we got some green gel. Yep, got some green gel. Checkpoint. I'll just aim in that general direction. And I missed. Gotcha. Go, 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 go. I don't even care about the green gel. Go. syringe. Those are always useful. We had a door over here. So bad at this. Hey. Who? Okay, so... Right. And here I thought I could just sneak up on him and stab in the back of the head. For some reason, I just suck at that. I think those are grenades. Yes, those are grenades. That would suck to get blown up by. That would also suck to get blown up by. I see a blue. There we go. Sneaky. Oh, it's another one of those battery things. Okay. Let me just get my composure here. There's some matches. There's another door over there, too. Look like heating coils, like something you'd see in like a stove or a toaster or something. So watch out for that. Did it get more red to you? I feel like it did. Can't open that. It's okay. It's alright. Everything is gonna be okay. We just gotta get through this. We can do this. We got this. I'm getting cold chills as we speak. I am thoroughly spooked right now. I just don't have a good feeling about this. Do not have a good feeling about this. And I feel even worse now, that checkpoint. Whew. Hey, disarm that. Boop. Don't want to get spiked. That would suck. Okay. Alright, alright. Oh no. Oh great. Oh look, hey, I was right. They're the heaty things. Oh my god. Ah! No. Shit, oh shit. Frickin', where do I go? Oh. Ah! Okay. Frickin' calm down. Alright, so... Screw you, peeps. Oh no, I can't go back. Ah! Okay. I see it. Okay. There'll be a time right now. Unfortunately, I feel safer.
What is this place?
My thoughts exactly, Sebastian. That frick. Oh, wow, that just... Frickin' all the music is gone and everything. It's just crazy. Okay. big guys. And there's one little guy. Okay, I wonder if I could take out the little guy. As I know, that axe that I had isn't gonna do squat against those big guys. So, I think I'm gonna have to either sneak past them, which my odds are like very low, or I'm gonna have to fight both of them, because I think I saw two. Big guy comes around again. I'm gonna throw the bottle, distract him.
He destroyed my box.
Now there's two. Ow! I know! I freaking know I have to freaking sneak. Ah! I died. Hey, I am dead. I'm dead if I had. So, first there's one. The second one comes out, and he's all like, hey, what are you doing with my friend here, huh? So. Throw the bottle. Leave. And never come back. Great deal. Great deal. Now, this, I think I can get a little bit of a jump on. Oh, what? Okay, I killed one. I killed one because I just freaking barraged him with nothing but bullets and stuff. Okay. Come get some. Okay, got him. Yeah, identified. My heart's beating. Heart's really beating. Okay, grab that axe, because I might need it later. Green gel. Those guys took a little. Ooh, hey, you're not getting me another time. Alright, is there any more ammo or anything around? Believe there was. Alright, now let's go freaking. Oh, it's a crank door. In here? Yeah. What is that?
Everything I have, everything I am, has been taken from me since the accident by those who seek to consume me. They're in the darkness, with only the phantoms of my mind to comfort me, to taunt me. I nearly lost myself completely. But then I saw her. Deep down I know she was only an apparition. But I would regain my face, recover what was taken from me. Restore her, my beloved sister, Laurel.
My sister. That was who he was with in the barn. It was on fire. She saved him. But she died. I'm guessing she kind of just burned to death. Unless she didn't. I'm thinking she did. Oh, hey. How come I didn't hear the music? How come I didn't hear no music? I just had to recognize the thing on the door. Oh. Journal of Sebastian Castellanos, February 27th, 2012. I've watched friends and colleagues die before, part of the job that I've taken, and it's never easy, but nothing can compare to losing your own child. I'd die a million times over to prevent it, but I can't. I felt so helpless when they lowered that tiny coffin into the ground. The pain is unbearable. I know I shouldn't, but drinking is the only thing that lets me sleep for the last few weeks. I'm worried about Myra. This has been extremely hard on her, and her way of handling it has been unnerving. She wants to be alone, has taken to staying up all night. She says she's doing work to keep her mind off of the tragedy, but she seems to be closing herself off to the world. I know it tends to happen when couples lose a child, and I hope that we're strong enough to avoid it.
Have you forgotten something?
Perhaps. Missing Patrick Higgins, lawyer for the Victoriano family. Last seen meeting with a man believed to be a client. Hey. House, home, destroyed by fire. Home destroyed by fire, daughter of police officer among victims. The bodies of Lily Castellanos, 5, and babysitter Juanita Flores, 56, were found in the charred home. Both of the child's parents are police officers with the Crimson City Police Department and were on duty at the time of the fire. Police are investigating as a possible arson. I have a key, because I got it. Actually, I think I have two. I want to say I have two. I'm not sure. I have two. Yes. I still have this locker, too. Boink. Okay. What other locker should I open? That one. Ooh. Boink. Nice. And this one. Ooh. Boink. Aw, yeah. Time to go do some upgrading. Abilities. See, now I can up one of these and it be okay. Like my maximum sprint time. Bam! Now it's 6 seconds. Oh yeah. That's the fastest I've ever ran. I mean, longest. Alright. Let's make it so the shot is OP. Let's frickin' do this. Yeah. Alright, so we're gonna do shot. And then we're gonna do. And then. We're gonna do. Fire rate. Remember, making a shotgun OP. So, maximum sprint speed up. I got more shotgun shells, shotgun's now faster and stronger. And yeah. Okay. So now we get back to it. I still think it's kind of weird that you can't hear the music. Okay. So now I go through these doors. That's not good. That is not good. Go, 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 go. Go under Sebastian. Go under Sebastian. This thing. No. Oh, no, no, no. I'm dying. I'm sorry, Sebastian. Maybe I should have increased the sprint time a little more. A little bit more. No. A big jar of green gel. That is why I thought it'd be a good idea to get it. But I used all my sprint, so. Okay, so at least we know that she will not be able to get through until I open that part. Made it. congratulatory box smash. Jeez. Okay. Now I'm wondering if I'll encounter her again. Full than not. Shit. Oh no. I gotta hit her with fire. She's probably gonna do it. Okay, I just noticed that my health's almost like a bare minimum. Can't see what you can't done. Yeah, see. Oh. Oh, I get it. I have to. Ooh. Okay. Oh shoot. Oh shoot. Wow, shoot. Oh, it's so creepy. Okay. really fast crawl is the creepiest thing ever. Come on, give me a break. It just, oh jeez. See, you won't let me catch a break here. I'm looking for valves, and I'm watching out for your freaking scary ass. Give me a valve. Oh, come on, I press circle. See, now that just freaking was stupid because I pressed circle and Sebastian, like, he was like, oh, did I run out of matches? I don't know. Like, it'd be good if I could frickin' dig this, like... That! Bow. You know, I'm really starting to hate her. I dislike her very much. She's scary. She's mean. She's not very pleasant to look at. Oh, I have to do this again.
Thank you. find a way to catch her on fire. Do it, Sebastian. He's like, what would I do? Focus mode there.
Joseph couldn't. Too bad they dragged you into this. But either way, you're mine. To do with as I please.
Those arms. Those mug looking arms. Hey, look at this. Got an arm. was intense. I actually died a few times. That's why I just went into focus mode, trying to figure out how to freaking do it.
Shit, back here again.
Back in this room, I believe this is the door that this is kind of confusing.
You're doing?
Trying to save us.
Really? Because it looks like you're making another monster to me.
I don't have time for this, detective.
Neither do I.
Leslie has been here before and made it back. He survived being linked to Ruvik, the only patient ever, as far as I know.
Wonderful. What does that have to do with any of this?
He's our way out, Detective. Our only way back.
That sound!
No, it's working. Didn't it? That's it. That's why.
Doctor, run!
He wants the same thing as us. He wants out!
Okay, so Dr. Marcel is dead, crushed by that giant creature.
Huh? Hey, I know you're out there. Listen to me, goddammit. Ruvik must be really pissed now. Breaking a stem terminal? Never thought he'd go that far.
Wait, stem?
Oh, he must be close if he's severing ties with the past. All he has left is his connection to the present. The full stem in the hospital.
Hospital? Beacon Mental Hospital?
That's where he'll be. Waiting for him. If somebody doesn't get there first, there'll be no way out for anyone!
You have an odor of blood about you.
Irregularities at hospital. Investigation uncovers irregularities at mental hospital. Situation more complex than thought. Internal audit at Beacon Mental Hospital suggests patients missing. Chief of Staff Marcelo Jimenez cites clerical errors. Dr. Jimenez. That's Marcelo. Huh. Missing. Dr. Marcelo Jimenez, Chief of Staff of Beacon Mental Hospital. Last seen in his office where he made a number of telephone calls. Huh. That's not a lot. Do I have any keys? I'm not even sure. I do have a few. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Doubt I'll get all of them. Okay, so save and then continue on. Scary thing. Probably be the biggest monster I've ever faced. Getting gold chills. Thought he couldn't find me. Oh my god.
He's got some weird eyeball looking for me. Say safe, but it's better than being out there. Okay, so I have to fight. What am I gonna do? I have no idea. To do. This boss appears to be too big to fight, like, real close. Probably just freaking grab me and just, you know, kill me immediately. So. Here we go. Oh, sweet. I got hide under this car. This is probably a terrible idea. Okay, we made it to the other room. There are two. What I see. And he is just patrolling. Now, the only hits I've gotten are the ones I've seen. Come on. Would I be able to, like, get cheap shots on him from here? Get a really tight angle here, and then when he comes in there, just shoot him. Oh shoot. Where the hell was that room? Hide under the car. Knows where I'm at. Nope, can't reach me from over here. There go my rooms. Oh, fantastic. Oh, great. It just ate me. Oh, I did. I had to go into focus mode. I kept freaking dying. It was stupid. Oh, jeez. Okay. Whew, okay. Oh, man, this thing's freaking ugly. Glad it's dead. Oh, jeez. Alright, now to go and collect my bounty of stuff that I totally didn't get. Both rooms destroyed. And, haha. Okay. Jeez. Ugh! Okay, that chapter was hard. In any sense, because there was the whole thing with frickin' the long hair lore of person, whatever. She kept frickin' killing me because I couldn't get to the things. I couldn't shoot the valves and stuff. And then, once I got past that part, got through everything, and then it was all like, hey, guess what? We're gonna throw this frickin' giant creature at you. Oh man, that was hard. But we did it. We did it. Chapter 10 clear. It was stressful. It was scary. It was challenging. And there was plenty of mistakes that I made on my part. It was a good chapter. I love this game. So, thanks everybody for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you want to see more, you could always subscribe. Once again, I am Peachy117, and I will see you next time.